Hello and welcome to Goa 365's Face to Face. With me is a familiar figure, Dr. Poornam Sambhaji. Doctor, welcome to our show. Now, Dr. Poornam is a pediatrician and a neonatologist from North Goa. She is the honorary secretary of the IMA, the Bardesh branch. She's also the chairperson of Mission Pink Health and the Women's Doctors Wing, as well as the ex-honorary secretary of the Indian Academy of Pediatrics, Goa chapter. Dr. Poornam has been in the forefront of creating awareness as far as this COVID situation is concerned, as far as pediatrics is concerned, and mothers. She's very active on social media and she has been on our channel also. So I would like to start off this program with some of the queries that, doctor, you get, because there is a lot of misconceptions, there are a lot of things that people don't understand, people don't know on social media. So what do you normally get, Dr. Poornam?
Okay, so normal questions, I would like to divide them, like, you know, as far as pediatrics is concerned, the questions that I'm getting recently about the third wave, the envisaged third wave, I would say. Then questions regarding the breastfeeding mothers. And then there are a lot of questions regarding misconceptions in vaccine, taking the vaccine, and all the questions related to vaccine. So these are a few of the broad categories, I would say. And each category is a broad question and answers within itself. Okay, the first question that is asked to us is, what is the possibility of the third wave? Okay, so for this, we all have to understand what is a pandemic and what is the characteristic of a pandemic. Okay, so pandemic means when the whole world is affected by one single disease at almost the same time. So now we at this time, our generation is seeing this one huge pandemic of COVID-19. Now, because of media, because of news, because of social media, we are connected all over the world, and that's how we are getting so much a huge amount of information now, which was not the case in the older time when, you know, there were pandemics even earlier. So now if we see the history of pandemic from the previous times, like, you know, there were so many pandemics earlier, we see that each pandemic comes in waves. It always comes in waves. So first wave will come, it will go down. Then the second wave will come, then it will go down. Then again, the waves will go on coming till a time the pandemic either has its own death, because maximum population becomes either infected and immune to it, or gets vaccinated and gets immune to it. Or in another words, gets even asymptomatic infection. Now, many of you say, no, I'm symptomatic COVID, I'm asymptomatic COVID. Means what? Maka, if I get cough, cold, fever with chest infection, I'm a symptomatic COVID. But if I don't get any symptoms, but just because someone else was positive with whom I was in contact and my test comes positive, I become an asymptomatic positive COVID patient. So some people, whether symptomatic or asymptomatic, they develop the infection and then they develop the immunity towards it. Now, what is this immunity? It's the fighting power of our body against a disease. Now, eventually, when all these waves come, maximum population for each disease, it is different. Like for COVID, they have said around 75 to 85% of population, when it will get infected or will get immunized, then we are going to form a level of immunity, so that, you know, the pandemic will die its own death. Now, when it will die, we don't know. Till then, we have to be ready for the waves. Now, regarding the third wave in specific, many bodies said that yes, it is going to come. An equal number of bodies are saying that no, it may not come. So we are still in the dilemma whether it will come or no. At the same time, we should be ready for the third wave. We should be ready if it comes. We should be ready mentally, physically, and infrastructure-wise and administration-wise. Okay. It shouldn't be like the second wave. What happened in second wave, that we knew that it is going to come, but we were not ready. But I think this near that for the third wave, we know it is going to come. It may or may not, but we know, we are envisaging that it will come, and we are getting
Doctor,
ready.
Doctor, what
for
do you
it.
Think? What do you think? Will it come? Is it expected according to history, according to precedence? Will this wave come in whatever form?
Yes, it is expected. I would say rather than expected word, I would say it is envisaged rather than the word expected. Okay, it is envisaged. Okay. It is being predicted that it may come somewhere in October, December, January or October, November, December, January. One of that time. So if it comes, we should be ready. If it doesn't come, thank God it didn't come.
Okay.
That should be our way of risk.
Yeah. As part of the preparation for this envisaged third wave, what are the common misconceptions that people should be aware of, or so as not to get fooled by it, or to go forward in many of the things that that we're coming?
Yeah. So misconceptions are, I would say, certain things that people should do so that we don't go ahead with the third wave. Is first and foremost, follow your SMS, that is your safe distance, your mask, your sanitization plus vaccination. So now we should change this SMS to SMS-V. Okay, so it is okay. Safe distance, mask, avoiding social gatherings, so soap and hand hygiene, okay, and vaccinating yourself. A lot of misconceptions regarding vaccination, a lot of hesitancy from the people's the end also for vaccination. Now, first, the problem was with the availability of the vaccine. Yes, there will be some or the other problem with availability because we are such a huge population. We as India are a huge population. Definitely, to serve to these many populations, our vaccine production has to be at that level. Okay, and this was not something which was expected. So you cannot expect companies to have huge amount of vaccination just for the sake of it. They have to understand the the requirement of the vaccination. Then only they will go for that many vials, right? So presently, we see that many times government is providing with the vaccine, but people are hesitating to take it. Okay, so
why?
Here, when there is supply and demand should be both go hand in hand. When there is supply, people should take it up. Okay, many a times we find people are hesitant. Vaccine is available, but people are hesitant.
Why?
Yes,
why, doctor?
People want to take and... Yeah, why? Because of misconceptions like when we take vaccine, you know, many people feel, okay, I'm breastfeeding, I may not be able to take this vaccine because I'm breastfeeding the baby. Second, many people have these misconceptions like I'm having diabetes, I'm having asthma, whether I should take this vaccination. Then many people have the queries like, okay, I'm planning to get pregnant or we want to go ahead with the child. And whether we should get vaccinated. So there are multiple of these misconceptions which are sitting in people's head. There is few days back, one of my friend who himself is a professor. Okay, so a very well-educated person. He called me saying that, Dr. Poonam, I want to go for vaccination, but I have got a slot which is a little bit far away from my house. So I have to drive over there. Okay, so my question is, like, if I get the vaccine, will I be able to drive back home? So you can imagine, even in people who are very highly educated, they have such type of misconceptions in the mind. Rather, when we have taken the vaccination, we as doctors have taken vaccine, we have like finished our OPD, the regular work of ours. In afternoon time, we have taken our vaccination. We have restarted with our work as soon as the vaccination was taken. I mean, after the half an hour of observation, we have started with our work. I mean, no doctor sat quiet after taking the vaccination. We continued with our work. Similarly, there is no problem in driving your vehicle. There is no problem in eating various type of food. There is no problem in breastfeeding your baby after taking the vaccine. So, you know, these type of questions, I think individual questions, if we go through, I'll be able to tell properly.
Okay. Like, what are the general questions that you normally get, like say from mothers or to-be mothers?
Okay, usual questions that I get from mothers is like, you know, usually they will ask me, doctor, I am breastfeeding my baby. One minute, I'll just sit properly. Yeah, doctor, I am breastfeeding my baby. And is it okay if I take my vaccine and I breastfeed, or is it required that I have to stop breastfeeding for 24 to 48 hours? This was some wrong post which was going on around on the social media, that when you are a breastfeeding mother, you take a vaccine, please don't breastfeed your baby for 24 to 48 hours. Or the second thing that was going on is, when you are breastfeeding and you take the vaccination and you get fever, then you do not breastfeed your baby. Both of these are wrong. There is no science behind this. Okay. So if you are a breastfeeding mother, you can go ahead with the vaccination. I think 4th of June, the government of Goa has circulated one advisory. It is called Government of Goa State Family Welfare Bureau Directorate of Health Services Kampal. Okay, it is dated 4th of June. This advisory has stated in it that, in the number D point, it has stated that for a woman, ensure that there is no pregnancy, and in case you are breastfeeding the child, ensure that 45 days have passed since delivery. Now, this is advisory from the Goa government, okay, for breastfeeding mother. So as of now, presently, what you can see is that you are 45 days post your delivery, that is your baby should be around 1.5 months old. After that, you go ahead with the vaccination. Now, international advisory hasn't taken this point, okay? International advisory doesn't have it. Goa government and I think Indian government has taken this point because of, just to be on the safer side in case of mothers who are post-delivery, because there are some incidences of untoward effects during this case. So they are still studying that population, and that is why they have said be careful for ladies who are just 45 days post-delivery. But yes, 45 days and plus, you can go ahead with the vaccination. No need of stopping breastfeeding after the vaccination. No need of getting scared. Even if you get fever after vaccination, you can go ahead and breastfeed your baby.
What about other things that people ask you in generally?
Okay, so I'll just tell you one question which had come across to me. When the person called Stephen Fernandez has asked me, okay, thank you, doctor, for all the informative videos that you're sharing. You are the best. Okay. So what he wants to know is, a person with diabetes about 250 always and also has 300 cholesterol level, is it safe to take COVID vaccine? Now, these type of multiple questions people have, mostly they are related to their diabetic regarding their cholesterol levels. Okay. So even people with this similar condition, like those who have diabetes, can go ahead, take their vaccination. Those who have cholesterol, those who have hypertension, can go ahead, take their vaccination, because cholesterol and diabetes is not a contraindication for the vaccination. Understand? So these are the type of regular questions that I get. This is one. Then there is one more question I'll just tell you. Then there are many people who are under the impression, like, you know, they have heard of some few people, they've heard that after taking the vaccination, okay, like LV Fernandez has asked me, doctor, why is that many people got COVID after first dose, especially after 10 days? If the person is suffering from major disease and he's not aware of it, can he go ahead with the vaccination? So these are the some questions that I get. So first answer is, why people can get disease after 10 days. So the thing is, after taking two doses of COVID, then you get immune to it. And also, immunity also depends upon your body's response to the vaccine. It is not that I give you the vaccine and you just develop an antibody. It is your body which is fighting against this vaccine so as to develop that pratikar shakti, that immunity, as we say, okay, the power to fight back with the disease. So along with the vaccine, it depends upon your own body's response. So your body has to respond to get the antibodies, right? So after taking the first dose, the antibodies will not automatically develop. Yes, you have to take the second dose also. After first dose, some amount of immunity will be there. After second dose, it will be boosted. And following the second dose, after 3 to 4 weeks, they said the immunity develops. So after that, you get protected against the serious side effects of COVID. No COVID vaccine told you ever that after taking the vaccine, you're not going to get COVID anytime. You're not going to get the serious effects of COVID. This is what is already always stated. Okay, because if you don't follow your SMS, definitely the COVID is going to hit you. You have to follow, whether after taking the vaccine, before taking the vaccine, you have to follow your safe distancing, mask, and hand sanitizers. And this habit has to continue. That will not stop so soon.
Yeah, actually, in fact, this is a good point that you came up with, doctor, because we find in Goa that even people without taking a vaccine, they have to go to the markets and crowd around mangoes and around fish.
Yeah.
And, you know, fish. See, fish. If you see the visuals of us that we see, and when we go into the markets, and when we go, it is very messy. Now, what basically you're saying, that even with a vaccine, two doses and 15 days or so after that, even then you have to maintain distance and you have to use masks. Are you saying this? I want you to reiterate and restress it. Please tell me this.
Yes. Even before taking the vaccine, while taking the vaccine, and after taking the vaccine, see that you follow your CAB, that is COVID appropriate behavior. That means you have to wear your mask properly, and it should be a double mask. So many of them ask me, what is this double mask? So today I kept this just to show you what is double mask. So you have to wear your surgical mask, which you get in the market. So surgical mask is something like this with two sides. Okay. And your cloth mask. Okay. So both these things have to be worn. And when you wear the surgical mask, I have made an entire video on this, only the dangers of what dangerous mistakes that you make while wearing video this thing. So, you know, this is very, very important. Okay, so this, you have to wear the mask properly, and proper wearing mask, the way of wearing the proper mask is also important. So when you wear this surgical mask, you have to tie these knots, this side that you see, no? Okay, you have to tie it at the end of the mask here, or you have to just twist it, one of the things. And the mask has to be worn, suppose if this is you place the mask, you twist this, see this, I'm twisting, put it across your ear. Now again, this side you twist, put it across your ear, okay? Pull it down. And this area that you see, just tuck it in. And now what is the importance of this other mask? Because this area which remains open, you can see here and here, these areas which are remaining open, the virus can enter from there. So when you wear your cloth mask, you hold it like this, you put it across your ear. Now you see, there is hardly any space that the virus is getting. Plus here it becomes easier, okay? So you have a double filter. At the same time, all these openings which will be there in a surgical mask will not remain if you wear double mask. So this is very important, double masking now. Because single mask can save you around 56%. Double mask goes to around 85%. And an N95 mask, which we wear, many of times you see people wearing N95 mask like this, that protects you around 95%. Okay, so N95 also you have to hold. Your N95, you don't require double mask. Many people I see wearing double mask with N95. N95 itself is enough. So you just hold the N95, put it on your ear, press here, that's it. It covers almost the whole area, see. It will not allow the air to pass inside. So that is about the N95 and the surgical mask, so the double masking. And hand washing, you know, and the sanitization, most of us know that, but you have to practice it. Just knowing is not important. You have to practice this.
Absolutely.
And you know what, it is very important. We find even in our clinic, when you tell the simplest of the thing to the parents, no, or to the patient, that is the most difficult thing that they cannot follow, because it's the habit. You have to change the habit.
But Dr. C, now yesterday the Chief Minister himself said that they had given as a priority parents of children above 5 years
as
a priority to get vaccinated. Below 5 years, yes. Below. Now yesterday he said that there was not very good response, so has increased it to below 10 years. So why is it that people are not, and why should they go? Why is it that people are so scared? What are they so scared? Is there a reason and need for people to be scared?
Okay, so for, I think one thing is the registering through the app, which many people are having problem with. you know, many of us find that people are trying to register, but they're not getting the slot. So somewhere the government has to find out some way of, you know, allowing these parents to take the vaccination. Maybe as they are forming the Tika Utsav, wherein you can directly go. I think in Tika Utsav, there is no requirement of going through the app. They can go directly walk in and get registered in the Tika Utsav. I think that is what it is, right? So that way people will be able to go. Many people are still not very tech savvy, you know, going through the app and all, they are not able to do. So that is one. Number two, many people are like, you know, not finding that, suppose they get appointment at so and so time, then going at that time is becoming problem for many parents, because, you know, many of them are nuclear families, children at home, you cannot take children to the vaccination center. Okay, who's going to look after the child? So I do have parents asking me, doctor, I'm going to take vaccine today and my husband will take after 3 to 4 days, because someone has to look after the kids at home. Okay, so there should be a little bit pliability or maybe flexibility in the timings for these parents so that they can get the vaccination during that time. Other questions that parents feel, you know, again, as I said, breastfeeding mothers, I have got 4 or 5 questions this way. Like, suppose I take COVID vaccine today and I'm breastfeeding the baby, my baby is due for her whatever vaccine in the next 2-3 days. Is it okay if I take vaccine today, I breastfeed the baby and I go for the vaccination for my baby after 3 to 4 days? So basically they are worried like whether the COVID vaccine that they have taken will affect their baby's vaccination. So absolutely no, because this doesn't get transferred to the baby as a vaccine. The antibodies will go to the baby and they are not going to affect the baby's vaccination per se.
So all vaccinations have to be done of all the kids, even after the, suppose if you're breastfeeding or whatever, parents, you have to do all the vaccination of the kids.
Yes,
as
yes.
Normal, as usual.
Yes, all the kids vaccination will go exactly the same way they used to go earlier. Okay, now many parents are scared to give children their babies vaccination because they are getting scared to remove the baby out from their house. So for that, I would request everyone, whoever is your pediatrician, please have talk with your pediatrician or request your pediatrician whether the vaccine will be available, whether an appointment can be taken, whether there are special slots available only for vaccination patients, or book your vaccine for 100% and then go and take the vaccine. It shouldn't be that you go the vaccine, I mean, for the baby's vaccine. I'm talking here about baby's vaccine, okay, not about COVID vaccine. So be clear. So when it shouldn't be that you have gone to the doctor and that vaccine is not available to you, then it will be waste of all your trip going there, then waiting for the doctor and all that stuff. If possible, take an appointment, go over there, take your vaccine during that time, come back. When you go to your doctor's visit, see that you carry extra sheet under the, which can be kept under the patient, so that you are sure you are placing your baby on the most cleanest surface. Because we do keep our clinics as much as possible clean. But you know what happens is when the baby comes, parents are very paranoid about babies. Okay, so they will usually, in my clinic also, they come, they put all that stuff on their my surfaces. I'm very well okay with it. So I always tell parents, carry your own towel or carry your own, carry all that thing so that you can place the baby on that. Carry your own sanitizer. There will be sanitizer in the hospital. Still, you carry your own sanitizer so that you clean your hands every time you touch here and there. Okay, see that COVID appropriate behaviors are there in the hall, clinic that you are going also. Most of the places it should be there, but see that it is that you are happy with the COVID appropriate behavior which is there in the clinic. So be sure about that. Go to the clinic, take your vaccinations. Should not delay it.
Okay. What I wanted, what is your message you feel to the parents of kids, and to parents of kids not only at a very young, slightly older parents also, what you feel, should be your message to them? Get vaccinated, take care. What is your general message that you want to give to them?
So my general message to them would be, take your vaccine at your turn. See that people around you are also taking vaccine. Motivate each other to take vaccine. Be positive about taking the vaccine, because you are going to form an umbrella for your child by taking vaccination. Okay, because you are going to decrease your chances of falling too sick with COVID, if at all. follow your COVID appropriate behavior even after taking the vaccine. So don't be under the imaginary fairy tale that I took a vaccine, now I'm a superhero. No, you are not. You have to follow your COVID appropriate behavior by following your mask, your social distancing, your sanitization. That has to go ahead. About the kids, their regular vaccination has to continue. If possible, the Indian Academy of Pediatrics recently, I think 19th of May or so, had taken an advisory wherein they have requested parents, if it is possible, go ahead with the flu shots. I think Maharashtra government has taken out this advisory and it was there in one of the newspapers, I believe. Okay, so go ahead, take your flu vaccination if it is possible. All those babies who have taken pneumonia vaccination, very well and good. If they have, if someone has not taken, please go ahead. Okay, so one few of these preventive measures. Now, at the same time, you have to remember, neither flu vaccine nor pneumonia vaccine is a direct protection towards COVID. It is only going to decrease the incidences of flu and pneumonia, which are caused by pneumococcal bacteria or by flu, by influenza virus. Because all these three, the pneumonia because of pneumococcal, flu because of influenza, and COVID because of COVID-19, behave in the same way. All will have fever, cough, cold, difficulty in breathing. Understand? So if the preventive measures are available against flu and pneumonia, so if possible, go ahead, take it, so that, you know, it decreases the number of patients because of flu and pneumonia.
Okay. Yeah, thanks, doctor. Thank you very much. And for everybody out there, now you've heard Dr. Poonam, especially for parents, kids, I think we need to get vaccinated. We need to ensure proper protocols and we need to keep distance. We need to keep wear masks even after getting vaccinated, second shot and 15 days. Thanks, Dr. Poonam. Thank you for coming on our show again. Thank you very much. And keep watching Goa 365.